Whakaro whātu, Elliot Ikilei here. Just wanted to have a very, very quick chat. I was harassed earlier today from our media team just saying, hey, you need to check this post out and please respond to it when you can. Now, the context of that post, of course, was at the Auckland University debate on March the 9th, I think it was, and the question came up about COVID and the economics around it. Now, I felt like people had been answering it pretty well, no problem. However, I wanted to flip the script a bit because, in actual fact, I've been a bit annoyed at the media. And the reason being is that when the coronavirus, when COVID was becoming more of a present issue, people, well, the narrative from the media was speaking out that, hey, Kiwis are racist, and that's why Chinese and Asian businesses are losing 30% business. And they kept pushing this narrative, and it just rocked me straight off. Because, as some of you will know, I'm married to a Singaporean Chinese. I'm married into the family. I know the culture quite well. I have, my friend circles are full of those people. So I have a bit of an insight. And the big one, of course, was that actually the most cautious group was actually the Chinese community, more so than islanders and Maori and the English and the other European nations, more than that. So this weird narrative that Kiwis were somehow the racist ones who were stopping to go to the Chinese shops and the Chinese restaurants and all those sorts of things was just nonsensical and continued a narrative that I saw. So I decided to flip the script and I just basically said that, well, hey, actually, it's not the Kiwis who are not attending. If you really want to push your ideas about who's not attending, you have to have a look at all of the groups who are involved. And that, of course, was the Chinese community. It was a Chinese community who abandoned the Yum Cha centres, who abandoned the Lim Churras and the Taipings and the Silver Bells, everything. They just stopped going. And in actual fact, if I go further, they viewed Kiwis, this generalisation, of course, but they generally viewed Kiwis as being far too lax and just increasingly, I don't want to say, well, the word that they use was stupid. So many of the ones who I talked to thought that Kiwis were stupid for not taking the issue seriously. And this is all the way back in January and February. So the context of the comment made was that, and that's how we got to that discussion. Now, when I said racism is not racist, it was quite fascinating because in a hall with hundreds of university students, higher education, of course, the vast majority were taken aback. You could see that from where I was sitting. And then some started laughing, some went like that, and some tried to bail me up afterwards on that. The reason why racism is not racist is quite simple, really. The behavior or the process of treating one race as worse than another or looking down upon or negatively discriminating one group of people and the ideas and the systematic issues around that is not held to one race or one ethnic group. It is something which occurs in every single people group on the face of the earth throughout the history of mankind. It is the one thing that is not racist, I would say, is racism. And so when I had a quick look through the comments about half an hour ago, I will give it up to Nate Brown and to Daniel Tither. I've never known how to say your surname properly, brother. Sorry. But Nate Brown, I'll give you a first prize because you jumped in there first and you were able to speak it out. So well done. It's a very simple aspect. Now, since I am here, one of the interesting aspects as well is this weird new term saying that a minority group, whatever that is, cannot be racist because they don't have power. Now, that is not the most idiotic, but it is one of the most idiotic things that I've heard. Any person can be racist. Not only that, there is also a spectrum of racism that you want to look at. When I was with some of my Tongan mates years ago at a party, I would lean over to one of them, hey, brother, hey, toko, why do you want to eat your own dogs? And without a hesitation, often they'll just turn around, well, I didn't get to taste it because the Niueans already wrapped it up and took it home. Now, you may not get that, but it's pretty funny in Islander circles. So the idea of racism is racism racism if it's between friends, if it's banter, or whether it's bullying? Is it malicious? What is racism, and when does it become a problem? When does it impinge on our free speech? And when does it actually impinge on our actual safety? These are strong questions that we need to answer. Now, just a couple of observations I also have is there's another term that came up out of that university debate afterwards is POC, which is the woke, liberal, academic, leftist, whichever word you want to take, term for person of colour. And I have to say, sorry, I just cracked up because I was thinking, you're standing there telling me about, people of colour. I was thinking, when did it become okay to call coloured people just by switching the word and that somehow makes it okay? So honestly, it's crack up stuff. The idea that you can say, hey, no, not coloured people, people of colour, that's okay, it's inane. It's just inane. And it's academically disingenuous, I would say, as well. So we have those areas and those issues going on. Now, it's also interesting, I'll point this the other way too, is that when we look, I cannot stand the separation of one group over another. Now, I believe that we need to be all equal, one group of people, New Zealanders, whatever ethnicity or group of ethnicities you might be, then we must be all together as one group of people, all together going forward. The co-governance structures are wrong. This idea of having more privileges and benefits to one group, which is, of course, for example, your Māori seats, we want them gone. We want any co-governance structures, we want them gone. Anything that sets one group of people above everyone else, we want all of those gone because that is not equality, that is not fairness. I will say this, however, that is not, and I know I'm speaking something which some people don't like me speaking about, that is not institutional racism per se. That is, you could argue, institutional discrimination. And it is a positive discrimination. It's got negative ramifications, but it is a positive discrimination. That's why it's not racist per se. The apartheid laws, the laws in South Africa, those were institutional racism. The Jim Crow laws in the US, where if you're black, you had to go around the back to get the horrible taps and the horrible toilets, institutional racism. Let me say this very clearly. There is no institutional racism in New Zealand. None. Zero. Nada. There is zero discrimination in terms of your skin colour in a negative sense. No one can show it to me. No one has yet shown it to me. And no one can show it to me because it does not exist. It's very clear. What we do have is a very problematic area in terms of, again, treating one group of people above other people. That hurts everyone. So, that was just a very quick, brief area. Let's just say, yep, absolutely right, from Lara Butland Cathro, no one life is more than another. We all bleed the same. Seki, absolutely right. Well said. So, be well, keep safe. We're going to do more of these little clips. It'll be more Facebook Live-y stuff. Next time I'll probably answer more questions, I think, because I got egged on by that one. So, be well. God bless you. God bless your family. And God bless New Zealand.